so many things that's held us down. But now it looks like things are fine. All right.
Hey, Houston, how you doing? Hey, let's give it up for Amanda and Josh. You know, it shouldn't be lost on us that they were just up here telling their own personal story of what they've gone through here in this state. And I want to thank Vice President Harris for coming to Texas and for shining a light on what's happening to Texas families and Texas women. Thank you, Amanda and Josh. Listen, I'm Congressman Colin Allred, and with y'all's help, and God's grace, we're going to beat Ted Cruz. That's right. You know, That's right. You hear that, Ted? You hear that? Let's go, Texas. All right. Now, y'all know, I believe in a very different Texas than Ted Cruz does. Because I was raised by a single mother, a public school teacher, and we don't pay our teachers enough. We don't pay them enough. And so I relied on my community, on my teachers and my coaches, folks who went above and beyond for me. They poured themselves into me. It's because of them I became captain of the football team at Baylor, was a linebacker in the NFL, became a civil rights lawyer, and have served us in Congress for the last 6 years. And you know what? In my time in Congress, I've been the exact opposite of Ted Cruz. Because I never forgot where I came from. I never forgot the folks who gave me a chance. I've been the most bipartisan Texan in Congress because that's how you get things done. That's what we elect people to do. Because I know there are heroes out here right now who dropped their kids off at school, who went to work maybe for one or two jobs like my mom used to do. And I know you're hoping that your elected officials are working as hard as you are. But Ted Cruz has been all about himself for too long. Too long. 12 years is long enough. And I don't know. I don't know if y'all saw the debate the other night. Yeah? There's one thing I know for sure at that debate. It's that everything is bigger in Texas, but Ted Cruz is too small for Texas. He's too small. He's too small for Texas. You know what small people do? Is when you lose an election, you think, you know what, I'm going to try and overturn that election. I know many of y'all probably know where you were on January 6th. I know where I was. I was on the House floor doing my job. I remember when they locked all the doors. We barred the doors the president walks through to deliver the State of the Union with furniture that we usually use to hold paper. I texted my wife, Allie, who was 7 months pregnant with our son, Cameron. Whatever happens, I love you. Because we're the only former NFL linebacker in the room. And there's a mob at the door. Everybody's like, what you gonna do, Colin? And I went to public school in Texas. I'm not just gonna sit there. So I took off my suit jacket. And I was prepared to defend the House floor from that mob. That's what happened. At the same time, after he'd gone around the country lying about the election, after he'd been the objector to the results in Arizona, Ted Cruz was hiding in a supply closet. That's okay. That's okay. I don't want him to get hurt by the mob. The point is, there shouldn't have been a mob. There shouldn't have been one. And if you summon one, and then you run for United States Senate, you gotta lose your job. That's what you gotta do. And he's too small for Texas, because when 30 million Texans were relying on him, when the lights went out, he decided to go to Cancun. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that? If your neighbor needed help in a crisis, you would go check on them. Can you imagine having the privilege and the responsibility of representing our great state, and a crisis hits our state, and you think, I need to go check out the Ritz-Carlton in Cancun? You wouldn't do it. I'll tell you what, if you did and you ran for office again, you got to lose your job. That's what's got to happen. Singularly responsible for taking away a fundamental freedom from Texas women because you think you know better than Texas women and their families and their doctors, and you put in place this abortion ban, and you celebrate this abortion ban, you introduce at the national level 5 times a nationwide abortion ban, then you have to lose your job. Texas families. You know, Allie and I have been blessed with 2 healthy babies in Dallas in the last 5 years. I can't imagine if at one of our appointments the doctor would come in and says, a problem with the baby or with my wife, but there's nothing I can do because Ted Cruz thinks he knows better. That's not who we are. There's one thing I know about us as Texans, and I'm a 4th-generation Texan. It's that we believe in freedom, and this is not it. So here's what we're going to do. Here's what we're going to do, Texas. In 10 days, we're going to beat Ted Cruz. In 10 days. And when we do, we're going to make Roe v. Wade the law of the land again. No more of this. That's right. Beat Ted Cruz. For all the Texas families, for all the families who are looking for a senator who's looking out for them, I will never abandon you when you need me most. I will protect your fundamental rights. I will bring us together around our shared values. I'll remind us that we have more in common than what divides us. We might have come here on different ships, but we're in the same boat now. We're all Texans. We're all Americans. We have to have a leader who understands that. And so here's what we got to do, Texas. We got 10 days to knock on doors, make phone calls. We got to make sure Kamala Harris is the next president of the United States. We got to make sure we send Ted Cruz packing. And when we do, it won't be a win for me or for a party. It'll be a win for our state. Are y'all ready? You fired up? You ready to go? All right, let's do it, Texas. God bless you. And may God bless the great state of Texas.